Good morning, everybody. So open Logic and go to File, Movie, Open Movie, Command D to get to the desktop. If your video is on the desktop, that's a shortcut, nice little Apple shortcut, Command D. And then locate your video and open. You get this window that says Open Movie. And keep those boxes checked because you'll want to extract the audio and open the movie in the movie window. So OK that. Your movie will open, and if you just close it, it'll just appear here, but it'll also appear in Global Tracks. So just turn Global Tracks on. There's your movie, and just make that a bit larger. So there's the audio on an audio track. I can delete that track. And there's your video. If you need to find out the BPM, probably the best way to do it, or the quickest way to do it, is to go to your, let's just close that, go to your audio track, and in audio effects, go to metering, BPM counter, turn the BPM counter on, and then just let the track play and let that try and figure out the BPM. So it's saying that that's 110 BPM. So I'm going to double click to correct the tempo to 110 BPM. And then I'm going to try and align it now to the arrangement. So at the moment, if I play the click, it's not aligned. So if I just zoom in, let's try and align this then to the grid. I'll just turn the click off for a minute. So here, this here is the one. But that's not aligned, it needs to be over here. So if I just put my song position pointer here, I'm going to try and get this point over to bar 14. But the audio is locked to the video, so I can't move the audio. It'll just snap back in line with the video, so it's the video I have to move. So it's, as you can see, this PC, as I try to move it, it goes back. But if I then pick up the video and move it, I'll start to see this bit move with the video. So if I put my song position pointer at bar 14, it might make it easier for me to align. It doesn't look too bad. Zoom in. A bit more. Should be okay. Not quite so. Just to fine tune it, I can just loop. I'm looking at the wrong bit, that's why it's this bit here. So, some position pointer, move the video. Pretty close, I can get it closer still by zooming in. And I should be able to move it by option or alt clicking. I can move it more accurately. Okay, so that's aligned with the grid. Need to check further on, see if it's still in line with the grid. Oh, baby. So it's gone out. All time. What else would my
girl do? Like you.
seems to go out around about here. So I could put in, you might not have this problem. The track you're working on might be fine. But if I did need to change things, if I turn on tempo, I'm getting a consistent 110 at the moment. But if I needed to change that at any point, click on the tempo to create a node, and click again to create another node. I can create that. I can create tempo grids. So you might not need to do that. Just make sure you check your track at the end. If you're playing to a click, you'll need that in time with your grid. What you do then is you mute the audio, because you guys will be writing your own part to that video, to your video. So mute the audio, and then away you go to create your own music. What you'll need to do though, because you'll be sending me these tracks, these projects, so what you'll need to do is you'll need to go to File, Bounce, and then create a stereo bounce, which you will then re-import back into your range, and then solo. And that's just in case I don't have your plugins, or just in case I don't have your software synthesizers. Let's say you're using something that's not within Logic, I might not have it, so when I load it onto my machine, you might not get the sounds that you're after. So bounce, create a stereo bounce, re-import it back into Logic, and then File, Save. Save this on the desktop. So that will save the video, your arrange and your stereo mix. Here's my project over here. Let me just check to see if the move is in there. It hasn't put the move in. I'll put the move in and I'll drag it in. And just open the project again, just to make sure it's working fine. And then if you control click the folder and compress it, and rename it with your student number or group so that I know, and then you can Dropbox it or Google Drive, send me the link before next Wednesday, and then I'll have that ready for you on Thursday when you come in. Okay, thanks.